approach to public sector. One of the principles enshrined in the directive principles of the Constitution of India state, I quote, "The ownership and control of the material resources of the community are so distributed as best to subserve the common good," unquote. That the public sector was the core of our development program was underlined by the industrial policy resolution of 1948 and 1956. The 1956 policy was unambiguous in assigning the leadership position to the public sector. It stated that the state will progressively assume a predominant and direct responsibility for setting up new industrial undertakings and developing transport facilities. Public sector has acted as the underpinning of our industrial development, operating across critical sectors such as mining, steel, basic and heavy machinery, and infrastructure. In an economy that had to be built up virtually from scratch, the public sector became the driving force to bring India into the group of manufacturing nations. An industrial sector that could produce only the simplest of goods was transformed into manufacturing and infrastructure heavyweight with the capacity to create complex and diversified range of products. The rapid industrial scale-up through the public sector boosted the confidence of Indians. Public sector enterprises emerged as the major employers, providing livelihood to millions of people. They promoted balanced regional development and contributed to welfare of the communities and societies where they operated. Over the years, several public sector enterprises have emerged as global companies, actively participating in innovative and strategic operations across all geographies. The contribution of our public sector to economic development is indeed seminal. Distinguished participants, ladies and gentlemen, the evolution of the public sector is a reflection of India's story of economic progress. Public sector started as the chosen instrument to assert in economic development. Economic advancement led to increasing presence of the private corporate sector with agile entities running on the advanced techno-managerial practices. The government became comfortable in withdrawing from the sectors that could be served well by the private sector. At the same time, building social sector assets like rural housing, rural energy, called for the reorientation of the government's investment portfolio to maintain the fiscal balance. Our economy today is the third largest in the world on purchasing power parity basis. It has the space and the need for coexistence, both the private and public sectors. Continuity with change has been the defining feature of India's industrial policy. And if you look at from the policy statements from 1948 to 1991, how gradually it has evolved, and at every stage it could absorb the changes required, and the fundamental approach had been to take the ground realities into account for the future course of action. through the economic reforms of 1991, sought to restructure the PSEs and reorient their role. The fundamental philosophy of their creation as instruments for fostering growth and development of the nation has not wavered. The country needs a strong public sector to complement the efforts of the private industry. It underlines the need to bring in measures to strengthen the PSEs. As vital members of a thriving industrial sector, public sector enterprises must drive overall industrial and economic growth. It calls for increasing autonomy to enable PSEs to meet the demands of the market in a responsive manner. Managerial and commercial autonomy has been evolved on the profit-making central public sector enterprises through the scheme of Maharatna, Navaratna, and Miniratna. There are 17 Maharatnas, 14 Navaratnas, and 70 Miniratnas today. These measures, by providing the operational flexibility to respond quickly to market, have led to an improvement in their performance. However, the pressures of liberalization and globalization imply that we cannot rest on our laurels. Much more needs to be done to provide a level playing field between the public and private sector in terms of flexibility of operation and quicker decision making. A measure that can help in this process is the listing of PSEs on stock exchange. Listing will allow millions of the small and large shareholders to participate in their ownership, the collective action of which could stimulate the PSEs to better their performances. Distinguished participants, ladies and gentlemen, I am happy that this global summit brings together successful examples of the public sector enterprises in other countries. The experience of the government-owned companies varies from country to country. While each government has attempted to leverage the resources of their public sector enterprises, the models differ. The public sector model in different nations is a study in contrast. But by studying such models, we can evolve a suitable format that converts the needs of our economy and society. To my mind, the foremost challenges of the Indian public sector enterprise today is to increase their competitiveness to deal with the market forces. Management has to be of the highest professional level, enabling the attainment of the global benchmarks in productivity and efficiency and meeting the multiple objectives expected of contemporary global enterprises. Many of our public sector enterprises have emerged as examples in productivity and quality. Their business practice have to be studied and appropriately disseminated in other similar and less successful public sector enterprises. Management of human resources, including dealing with the existing skill gap, as well as forecasting and preparing for skills required in the future, have to be accorded priority. As custodians of the social development, a high degree of social engagement is expected from our public sector enterprises. Though central sector public sector enterprises are already discharging their duties in the areas of the corporate social responsibility, they would need to set an example for their private sector counterparts in view of the provisions laid down in the Companies Act for Act 2013. Industrial growth calls for high priority in technology development and innovation. Developing new products and process, entering new markets, and addressing new consumers have to be an ongoing business strategy. Public sector enterprises have to take a leading role in espousing the business behavior. Large corporate has to seek the global opportunities to leverage a dynamic and thriving marketplace. Many PSEs have active programs of overseas engagement. They have to strategize to seize the commanding heights of the global economy. A strong supply chain that links public and private sector is the potential of benefit for industrial sector and economy immensely. Strategies like smooth and facilitative systems of vendor payment, greater use of information technology, and greater engagement of the smaller firms have to be adopted to keep industrial operations stable and enable growth of all firms in the value chain. Distinguished participants, ladies and gentlemen, Indian public sector enterprises have been an integral part of the industrial landscape of our country. They have served as progenitors of Indian industry and stabilizers of Indian economy. As model employers and as leaders of the industrial community, public sector enterprises have contributed in many ways. I am confident that it will grow in strength and meet the heightened expectations of the nation. I compliment the Department of Public Enterprises and the Confederation of Indian Industry for undertaking this initiative. I wish you a very successful conduct of the conference, and it should be a very productive one. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Jai Hind!